out of high school, I moved to New York for a very short period, and then I moved to Los Angeles. I kind of craved a little warmer weather, and New York was a little intense for me when I was only 18. I was only there for a few months, and I just felt it was a little too intense without knowing someone or having school or something like that. So I moved out to LA, and I lived out there for many years in the 90s. And then I was gonna move back to New York, and I stopped back in Minneapolis where I grew up. Reed and Ethan and I in the Bad Plus, we all grew up in Minneapolis, along with several other musicians I continue to play with. And I met a couple of musicians that I formed the band Happy Apple with in Minneapolis, and that's why I decided to stay there. It's a great city for music and art and more of a band culture city. And we developed that band, and Reed and Ethan of the Bad Plus, who I grew up with, were fans of the band Happy Apple. We'd play New York and they would always come out, and so they asked me if I'd like to put together a group with them. And in 2000, we formed the Bad Plus in New York. And, we've been together almost 14 years now. One of the luxuries of having a working band is, you don't have charts on stage because everybody knows the music. That's one of the things we're very against, is jazz groups with charts on stage. Because, if you saw the Coltrane Quartet, they're gonna have charts on stage. Miles Quintet of the 60s. I mean, you know what I mean? You went to see the iconic bands of the golden age of jazz. They knew their music. Ornette Coleman, all these other things that inspired us. We want to know our music. So a lot of times I'll just teach Ethan, sit with him at the piano, work with him on the tunes, and then talk to Reed about what we want. But in the Bad Plus, we each write music separately, and the composer kind of has the right of way. But then we make it our own, through beating it into shape together. But it's usually pretty arranged by the composer. But then, we leave room for everyone to kind of hijack it. I've focused a lot of my career on my own music and my own bands. But I have done a lot of playing with different people. But I've also done rock records and things like that. I mean, for me, I just feel like I have to be sort of involved with the process. I'm not the best sort of anonymous sideman guy. And there's people that can do that, and they do it. It's an art to do that. But I'm a little bit more iconoclastic in the way that I kind of fit or I don't fit. My favorite drummers, especially in rock, let's say, but in every genre, but they really impacted the sounds of the groups they were in. So if they were working groups, they were never anyone you could anonymously sub out for someone like John Bonham or Jim Keltner or Stuart Copeland or someone like that. And then same with jazz. It's like, I can't think of Coltrane Quartet without thinking of Elvin Jones at the same breath as Coltrane. They're adjoined. They're not, I don't think of them as separate entities. I have always played Vic Firth sticks. Truly, honestly, I love them, and I've never played any other sticks ever since I was very young. I essentially ended up with the SD4, just like anyone probably picks their sticks, but for me it was to have a stick that was it's lightweight, but it's not short. So it's not like a short 7A length or whatever. And also the tip has a nice sound, a woody tone on the drum. It's very dark, and I really like that. So they're not super lightweight. There are lighter sticks out there, but they're not heavier, bigger, but they still have a weight to them and a dark warmth to them. The story is that I spent many years thinking I was a Vic Firth endorsee when I really wasn't, which is a very weird story, but I was told that I was. So I was thanking Vic Firth on all these records I was making, and I had some sticks that showed up at the office of the Bad Pluses manager, and I just figured that Vic Firth has given me some sticks, and that's so great. I didn't realize I was Vic Firth. And then about 5 years into this, I contacted Vic Firth about getting some more sticks, and they were like, you're not an endorsee. Would you like to be? They immediately, everyone over there, I can't remember who it was, but said, yeah, we'd love you if you were, but you're not. I'm like, well, I've been thanking you guys on records for 6 or 7 years now.
Let's make it official. Oh, that's awesome.